We have what is known as a tongue drum here. We'll be taking a look at creating this tongue using this sketch. The critical requirement here is that the length of the tongue on the curved face has to be equal to the length of the sketch rectangle. So essentially, we need to wrap the sketch onto the dome. However, this dome has curvature in two directions. It was made by revolving an arc, so the emboss command cannot be used here. Using the project to surface command within the sketch environment would also not work, as it produces a straight projection. In this particular design, we actually only need the length of the tongue to be wrapped, but not the width. So this means that we only need to consider the curvature in this direction. In order to perform the embossing, we can create a surrogate body. Begin a sketch on the front plane. Go to Create, Project Include, Intersect. Select the curved face. This creates a sketch entity that represents the intersection between the curved face and the sketch plane. Begin the project command and project the bottom edge. Extrude this profile symmetrically. The extrude distance does not matter here. Just make sure that it extends beyond the width of the tongue. Set the operation to new body, as you do not want this to merge with the dome. Since this surface has curvature in only one direction, it will allow us to emboss. Go to Create, Emboss. Select the sketch profile. For faces, click on the select box and select this face. The depth of the emboss does not matter here, as we only need to make use of the resultant edges. So how do we use these edges to create the cut on the dome? Here is where root surfaces can come in handy. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Root. Select these three edges of the embossed feature. For type, set to normal. Adjust the distance such that it goes beyond the thickness of the shelled dome. We can hide or remove the surrogate body. Go to Create, Thicken. Select the root surface body from the bodies folder. We want to thicken towards the outside. Adjust the thickness. Set operation to cut. So let's try to verify whether we have managed to achieve a wrap. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select this face to split. For splitting tool, click on the select box. And select this face. extend the splitting tool. Repeat the split face command. Select this face to split. And select the front plane as a splitting tool. Go to Inspect, Measure. Bring back the tongue sketch profile. If we click on the long edge, we can see that it is 40 millimeters. If we click on this split line, we can see that it is 40 millimeters as well. So we have managed to achieve a wrap lengthwise. Let's remove the split lines. If we look at the cross section, you can see that the cut is normal to the curved face. Depending on how you want to manufacture this, you might need the cut to be straight down. So how can we do that? Go back into the root surface. Set type to direction. For direction, click on the select box and select the vertical axis, which is the y-axis in this case. This produces a root surface that goes straight down. Let's confirm and let the thickness regenerate. If we look at the cross section again, we can see that the resultant cut faces are parallel to the vertical.